Hi there, my name is Vadim Mikhailenko from howtoanalyzedata.net. In this section, we're going to look at how you can create professionally looking 3D networking diagram in Microsoft Visio. So first thing you see is this screen when you launch Microsoft Visio. We're going to pick a blank drawing, or you can basically pick a detailed networking diagram. It doesn't matter because we're going to pick some stencils that will serve our purpose the best. As you know, when you pick the blank screen, you don't have any stencils here. So you have to select the stencils, and these are the shapes that you're going to use when you draw your diagram. So we're going to click More Shapes button, and we're going to click Network, and we are going to click Network and Peripherals 3D. I found that this is probably the most professionally looking. You might have different opinions, obviously, but that's what I like. And there are different shapes here. You have servers, ring network, pretty much all the items that you may ever need when you try to represent networking. We're going to start with servers, and we're going to take this server box, and we're going to bring it into the main screen. I kind of envision that my diagram will be more horizontal. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to change the view of the page. And to do that, I am going to go to design orientation. And instead of portrait, I'm going to pick landscape orientation. So this way I can represent better what I'm trying to represent. So this is going to be my first server. And what I'm going to do now, I am going to give the server some characteristics. And they would be the type of operating system that server runs, location, memory, IP address type, and give the server name. This is not necessary for every diagram. You have to decide what you specifically want to represent. But this is something that I'd like to represent here, because this is something that makes value and adds descriptive information for my viewers. So I've added the information for my server. I'm just gonna zoom it in a little bit. And there are a couple tricks you can use in order to see this in a better way. First of all, you can hide the shapes and stencils. This will give you more room on the screen to see it. You can unhide them as easily. Or you can zoom in and zoom out into the areas. This is the zoom in button, and this is the zoom out button. So what you see, it's a Windows Server 2012 located at Milwaukee Data Center. It has 8 gig of RAM, IP address, and this is the static IP. Now, I kind of don't like it when it's on the, at the bottom, so I'm going to move it to the side of the server box. In order to do that, I click once on the server, and you see this yellow box. This is where the center of the text is located. So all I need to do, I just need to drag this yellow box and move it to the left of the server. So I kind of like it a little bit more. Now, I also would like to add information for the server, like a server name, which is different from all of this descriptive information for the server. And if you want to edit this, you can. For example, if you want to say, okay, this is my OS, which stands for operating system, you can do that. And you can say, okay, this would be bold. And the operating system name is not going to be bold, and maybe location will be bold, and all this information will be bold. The type of information and the information itself will not be displayed as bold, right? So probably if you do that, though, you might want to align it to the left. Right now it's right aligned text. You probably want to align it to the left, and then this is how it's going to look. And then it probably might make sense to have it here. So it's just going to be more professionally looking. This is some interesting tricks of what you can use in Microsoft Visio. Now, as I mentioned, I'd like to add the server name. And to do that, I'm just going to bring in, there are a couple ways to do it. First of all, you can add text. And you can just bring a text box here. So you go insert, and you insert the text box. And you can pick between horizontal text box and vertical text box. I'm going to pick horizontal text box. But in my case, I like to prefer to insert callouts. They come in the different shapes. And for this particular server name, what I'd like to do, I'd like to insert this shape, and I'm gonna name it as a sales server 01, and this would be my server name. So it's not a dot, it's a dash 2. And this would be my sales server 01. And I'm just gonna make it bold as well. And you can choose fonts, you can pretty much apply any formatting that you like. And I'm gonna put it underneath of this server. Now, this is my first server. And the good thing is, now I can do copy and paste. I can, first of all, I can group these three boxes. I can select, it's actually two boxes, server box with the description and the callout in terms of Visio objects. So I can do a right mouse click and I can select group and group. And now I can drag it as a single object, which is very nice. And you can group as many objects as you need. So that's the purpose of the grouping function. Now, what I can do as well, I can copy this, and I'm just gonna show it through the menu, because you can also do it through the keyboard. So you did right mouse click copy, and then you did paste. And here you go, you got a second server, right? And the second server might run the same operating system, but will definitely have a different server name and different IP address. Document sharing 01, and I'm just gonna change IP address. So instead of, I have to ungroup it, unfortunately. Grouping, ungroup. And now I should be able to edit text. So this would be 02. I am going to copy it again. And I'm just gonna copy and I'm gonna do paste. So this is going to be my server 3. And this would be marketing box. Marketing files or marketing share. It doesn't really matter as long as it represents the actual names. For the purpose of this demonstration, I'm just gonna use marketing sharing. This would be 03. And now you can add some other features of the typical networking diagram. For example, you can add the firewall, and you can choose the size of the firewall. And if necessary, you can use connectors and connect your server to the firewall. If you choose to do that, you probably would wanna change the location and play with the location of the boxes. So it wouldn't overlap with your text. So probably if you're trying to display connections, it makes sense maybe to have firewall on the left. So let's do that. I'm just gonna remove this connector. I'm then gonna do Control Z, or you can do undo. I'm gonna switch back to pointer tool, drag the servers to the right, have the firewall on this side, and then use my connectors to connect the server here. And you can certainly play with the lines and make it look the way you want it to. So probably would make sense. This would be the most professional line. And you can have other features of the line, like arrows and some other things as you need to. So this would be my second line, and this would be my third line. It makes sense for it to go, kind of to display the network connectivity. In the previous section, we've created professionally looking 3D networking diagram. If you would like to learn more how this was done, just go back and watch the first video. In this section, we're gonna look how to make it look prettier and more professional. We just use default objects and default fonts and default lines from Visio. Now, I would like to add some specificity and make it look more professional and use more professional design scheme, maybe potentially adding some arrow endings and using some features of the Visio that are easy to use, but at the same time help you make your diagram look prettier. So first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna look at the lines. And you see that these lines, they don't have any arrows in the end. And Visio allows us to add arrows. Sometimes you want to show the data flow. In this way, it's bidirectional, right? It goes from firewall into the server and back from the server into the firewall. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go back to the home, click a pointer tool. This is where we can select the object and look at the properties of the object. And here we're going to look at what type of connector, first of all, we can use. Could be a straight connector, right? And this is the difference between the straight connector and the other connector that we had. I'm going to use undo button to go back. I like this one more. I don't like straight connector, but that's just my preference. I'm also going to look at the format shape. And here you see the format shape details on the right. And it shows what are the options that are available. First of all, we can change color. We can change the dash type. Right now it's solid, but you can use some dashes here if you want to. I'm gonna keep it as is. But what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna look at the begin arrow type, and I'm going to use this type of arrow. And I'm also going to do the end arrow type. And I'm going to use the same type of arrow. And I'm gonna do this for all the arrows. To me, it's more professional. You might disagree as a viewer, but good thing to know is that you have choices and you can choose something that you consider to be professional looking. So this arrows. Now, I don't like these colors. I mean, just because they're default and everybody's probably using it without understanding that there are some easy ways to make the color theme better. And I'm going to show this to you real quick. If we go to Design tab, we have Themes option, right? And you can just click here and see how many of those themes are available. I'm not a professional designer, but if I see something that looks professional, I like that. So if you're the same way, this is really helpful. And you can pick a different themes here. So for example, let's just try this one. And you can probably even move from theme to theme and pick something that you like. So let's say I found something that I like, which this one looked pretty similar to original one. But I kind of like the modern design, even though servers typically not depicted. So this is probably the best one. Now you have some variations of this. So once you selected the modern design, right, you can choose the color theme and play with the colors. Right, so there are a lot of different options for the colors. What you gotta keep in mind when you pick the design theme, keep in mind that it's most likely will be printed at black and white. So if you pick very contrast colors or something that would be on a darker background, it might be hard to see when you print it. So that's what I always try to keep in mind when I print such diagrams. And you see when you change the theme and variant, it also changed the stencils and shapes and how they're gonna look when you bring them over. So keep that in mind too if you're planning to add additional objects. You can also change and add background. So for example, if it's like a global network, you can put a global background if you like. So that also looks professional, but you might want to reconsider the variants and the colors once you do that. So this is probably going to look a little prettier. So hope you've enjoyed this video. And there are a lot of other options I would recommend you investigate by looking at Visio documentation. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this information valuable and enjoyed the video. Please make sure to check out my other videos on the subject, and please make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, if you want to learn more about Visio tips and techniques, you can do it on my website at www.howtoanalyzedata.net/visio. You can also check out the Visio training I recommend by going to www.howtoanalyzedata.net/visiotraining, and make sure to sign up for my email list. I'll keep you posted on the tips, tricks, and techniques and other promotions available. You can do it at www.howtoanalyzedata.net/email. See you next time.
Thank you for watching this video. My name is Vadim Mikhailenko, and I just want to tell you a little bit about myself. I'm an information technology consultant, and I'm also a public educator. I'm helping you to become more effective and efficient, and also be more productive with technology. I have myself 20 years of experience in information technology, and I worked for medium and large organizations domestically in the United States and also internationally. I enjoy learning new technology, and I believe that by using technology, you don't just change your own life, make yourself more productive, you can also change lives of others and change the world for the better. I'm a family man, and I enjoy spending time with my wife and four beautiful children. Thank you again for watching, and make sure to visit our website at howtoanalyzedata.net. You can contact me through the website. There's a contact form there. Thanks again for watching.